What's up, everybody? It is me, Ruby Jewel, and it is the Jewel Wrap-Up. And right now, I'm on the phone with Alander Pulliam. He's at Universal Music Group, and he's the director of marketing. So we're going to get a little bit into conversation about Universal and what's going on with him. He has some interesting projects coming up. So we're going to get to know Alander a little bit. So, hey, Alander.
Hey, what's going on?
How are you?
I am fine.
I'm glad to hear that. So, now you work at Universal, so let's talk a little bit about Universal Music Group. So you're the director of marketing, and so what you do is you kind of develop marketing strategies for, like, different companies. So explain a little bit about your job and what you do.
Well, just a little bit about my job. What I do at Universal Music Group is, like I said, you kind of know, but I develop strategies and campaigns, and I also propose marketing advances for campaigns that we are, you know, putting together. I also help with partake of putting the budget together for marketing campaigns for not just artists. It's like, so we do team up with, like, you know, cologne and Nike and Reebok, things of that nature. So what I do is I kind of help set up these companies, you know, see to deal with clients that we have that are releasing a lot of numbers on iTunes, a lot of numbers in sales, things of that nature. So I help put together the budget for those marketing campaigns, but also my main job is to help develop the purpose of the campaigns, kind of help generate and analyze.
So is that complicated, or is it complicated, because you've been with the company since 2013, do you ever find like you finally just get the hang of things and it's more easy to do, or was it really stressful, or has it been easy from the get-go?
Actually, it's I'm not gonna say stressful, but it was some challenges that I faced with it, because marketing is one of the biggest things that any company can have. You know, it's one of the most important things to a company. You know, you got to know where your foundation and where your product is going to relax and lie at. You know, and that's what marketing is. It's about not just developing a trend. So, you know, I found it hard and challenging to, you know, kind of say, believe it or not, a lot of people that go through marketing, you know, don't really last that long, because the difficult thing is knowing how to really break down the actual, you know, target audience. It's actually, you know, you got to know how to break down the overall, you know, you got to go through religion, so you got to get around different, you know, individuals. So the challenge is, you know, especially if you're a person like me, I like to observe before I do things, so I don't like really making mistakes. So I spent 3 years at Universal. My first 3 years at Universal was with no pain, because I was so passionate about the whole marketing aspect. But, you know, my first job was AT&T, and one of the biggest things we taught us all the sales and marketing, you know, and I always wanted to do it. It's one of the biggest things that teaches you entrepreneurship. Mm-hmm. And I think, if, you know, the challenge here was being able to communicate effectively. And that's what marketing and sales do for me. It helped me. So I kind of had not only the passion, but I knew what I was looking for when I was doing it. I was looking for an avenue of being able to do marketing for other businesses and other things that I, you know, have going on myself. So it kind of put me in that bracket. Now, you know, other challenges might be, you know, the competition. So, you know, That's one of the biggest challenges, because every label has this competitor, you know, Atlantic Records, Def Jam, you know, even though there's some of them umbrella labels under our company, we're still in competition with them, you know, so that's one of the biggest challenges, because you're trying to compete with one of their artists that are similar to one of our artists, and you're trying to break those numbers, so you're going in and doing research on those particular artists and bringing it back to, you know, us, and we go look over it, then we compare, and then we kind of come up with a whole other marketing,
right,
I think, you know.
So let me ask you this now. Ever since, you know, you've been there and you feel like you get the hang of things, you've actually branched off and now you're doing some other things. So now you're doing some TV producing, and I hear that you're doing kind of like a remake of, like, a spinoff to, like, Family Matters called Family Steel Map. So is that true? Is that what's going on right now?
And this is not speculation. We have actually confirmed it. is actually a school really built off family matters. Actually, we call it Family Still Matters. But what we did this time is we took some of the cast from the original Family Matters and we brought them onto the show. And it's a mix. It's Family Matters meets the Cosby Show.
And you have characters like, you know, Jeffrey Patton and Darius McCray, right?
That's like, Aquarius, Bill Murray Payton.
Right.
Jill Marie Payton, Reginald Bell Johnson. We got some new actors. I have Tommy Carter, you know, which was in Santa Claus 2 and Black Knight. Also did, you know, work with Meet the Browns. So, you know, the story is really centered around a family, you know, kind of like a Family Matters show. It's kind of like a, you know, middle class family. You know, the dad is a cop, police officer, the mother, trying to become a lawyer. So she's trying to take care of the kids at the same time. And the spin we did to it is the mother and father is different. And now the grandmother and the grandfather is, you know, the guy that played Claude Winslow. And then Grandma Ida is Joe Marie Payton. Mm-hmm. My purpose for this is I feel like there is no TV show out there that can, you know, mend families back together. And I feel like we're missing that. And that's what I was bringing back. I wanted a purpose. I don't want to stereotype any ethnicity anyways. I want to make everybody happy. I want to make sure, I always believe in, you know, healthy TV brings healthy households, you know. So if you've got a lot of unhealthy TV in your household, you know, you're going to have a lot of people that are unhealthy mentally, physically, you know, psychologically. And I feel like, you know, bring a TV show that has morals and values and lessons. And I feel like that's what we're missing. There's a lot of our generation that's out of, you know, under us that haven't had the experience with a comedy show and Family Matters.
Right. Yeah, because now, I mean, it seems like it was so long ago that we were watching, you know, the Cosby Show and, you know, Family Matters, which were it was a few other African-American family TV shows, but there was none like those. Those were the most, you know, really relevant, the most that everybody know now. So it's good for you to be bringing that back, kind of like a 2013 version of that, where the kids now can kind of experience what we experienced then when we were watching those shows, right? Because there's so many, you see so many other families, you know, out there, and so different TV shows with other families, and it's not really given that true aspect of a middle class African American family. So I think that's a great thing to be bringing that, because we kind of miss that right now. You know, and you don't see too much of that unless it's BET. So.
And I just feel like it's because I just got to bring it hard. You know, I just got to take it in, bring it hard, and as a matter of fact. Jill Marie Payton, that played Harriet Winslow, you know, she just signed on as co-producer. So that's a good thing, because, you know, she told me, we're about empowering.
Right.
We're not about hurting. We're not about taking away from people. We want to give you something that you can take with you when you go to sleep and when you wake up in your house. It gives you that energy and that drive that anything that you want to do, whether you're stereotyped or put in a box, that you can get out of it, whether you're in a low-class family or a middle-class family or a wealthy family. So that's my purpose for the TV show is, you know, it's really built off of that, and then my youth foundation, you know, it's kind of like that. So
when are you planning on, you know, when are you done, like, wrapping up and planning on releasing it? So when can we expect to see the new addition to Family Matters called Family Still Matters?
Oh, we're expecting the slated date is December 25th. It's Christmas. The network actually came up with that idea that, you know, get everything done and wrapped up by, you know, Christmas Day. Eric, the first day of Christmas, you know.
Okay.
We figured that families are going to be in. So, that's going to be a great day.
Okay. So where can we, you know, learn more? Where can the people, should I say, learn more about you and what you have going on, and, you know, even, are artists able to submit things to you? Do you have, like, an email or website where artists can actually submit to you?
Actually, they can email it to me. They can email it to me, and it goes to my assistant, but, right, you know, my assistant is right next to me all the time, most of the time. Like I said, my email is alander.pulliam, that's A-L-A, N-D-E-R .pulliam, P-U-L-L-I-A-M @umusiconline.com. So that's umusiconline.com.
And now, do you have Instagram and Twitter?
You know what? I have Twitter, I have Facebook. I do not do Instagram.
Okay, so what's your Facebook and your Instagram? I mean, and your Twitter?
My Twitter is twitter.com/Alander_Pulliam. That's my first and last name. And then my Facebook is facebook.com/Alander Pulliam. So everything is Alander Pulliam. Twitter, Facebook, even AlanderPulliam.com. You can kind of see a little bit more of everything I'm doing and working on right there. You can also go to OurFamilyMattersTV.com. It's still in progress. Like I said, we are going with TVS Network. So, and also with my company, LBN TV Network. So,
I'm excited to check it out and see the new and improved Family Matters. It's actually called, Family Still Matters. So thank you so much for, just talking to me today and sharing a little bit, about you and with the people. And, I hope everything just flourishes for you, everything you're trying to do in this business. And everybody, make sure you go to Facebook.com and check out Alander, or you can go to Twitter and check out Alander. And you also said FamilyStillMatters.com, right?
OurFamilyMattersTV.com.
So thanks again, and I appreciate you for stopping by as a jewel wrap-up. Thank you so much.